everybody, welcome back to Black Phoenix Entertainment. This is Judge My Riding, episode 10, and yes, it is the last and final episode of Judge My Riding ever. I am clearing out all the rest of my clips for this video, so we got 13 clips to go over. It's going to be fun, it's probably going to be a little bit long, but we got some cool stuff to talk about and some interesting clips to talk about. And I'll talk about why I'm ending it later in the video, but with all that being said, let's go right to the first clip. Alright. So I like to play these clips sometimes further back for more context. Sometimes when you get a short, like 3 or 4 second clip, you don't get exactly what's going on around you. So I'm going to play this so you can see the entire road ahead of me. You can see the cars coming here and you can see the side streets. And you see this red car just popping its head up there, waiting, and then just goes. Like this, this guy had plenty of time to either A, just wait for me to pass, or B, just go. You could have just gone, but this is one of those things where people just hesitate and wait, and then they panic, and then they just go in front of you. So you just got to be aware or something like that. So let's just move on to the second clip. All right, this one is completely out of nowhere. Now, I know this area, and I know there's a spot there where cars go, but this was totally unexpected. I'll just play this here. You can see a little bit of red. Boom, just goes. And takes his time doing it. Like, comes out of absolutely nowhere. If you're not familiar with this area at all, you would never expect there to be... It's not even a road. You can't really see it from the camera view. It's literally just enough space to park one car so you can go along like a walking trail or something like that. That's it. So, I mean... Guy had plenty of time to really see me. And then again, this is one of those panic moments for a cager. They're like, oh my god, I'm just going to hit the gas and just go. Instead of just doing a polite thing and stopping and letting a bike or whoever else go. It's just, yeah, a little bit crazy. Had plenty of time to stop and, you know, slam on the brakes and stuff. So as far as an immediate danger, non-issue. It was just being aware of, hey, that guy's pulling out. I should probably hit the brakes. Let's move on to the next. All right, this one... I'm just going to play it as I talk. Basically, someone merging onto the highway and just cutting all the way across. Distance was fine. It's a total, like, you know, as you can see, it wasn't super close. I really just had to let off the throttle a little bit. But that's something you got to watch for. People immediately get on the highway and they have this urge to just cut all the way across for whatever goddamn reason and then just go, like, below the speed limit. So... That's just, let's watch those people. Even if you're in the leftist most lane, still, you got to keep an eye on people merging onto the highway. We're going to bang through these. I got 13 clips. Let's move on to the next. All right, here's another one. Set a little bit further back. You can see a lady on the side street there. And again, it's an ongoing theme. It's like you saw me, and then you pull out as slowly as possible. Like, even from back here, we can see each other. I know she's there. She knows I'm coming up at this point, and there's no one coming the other way, and I can't really see in my mirrors, I don't think there's anybody behind me, but even still, it's like, alright, like, slowly pull out, like, whatever. It's the same as the rest of the videos there. Panicked, just pull it out in front of you. Just be aware of it, and brake, let off the throttle, do what you gotta do to make sure there's no collision there. Let's bang out the next video. Alright, this one isn't a huge deal, but it's something that has become my biggest pet peeve. And that's people not stopping whatsoever for red lights or stop signs. You see this guy just pull out? Boom, just goes. I'm going to stop this for a second. You can see, there is a stop sign there. He does have a stop sign, but he just... No attempt whatsoever to stop at this four-way intersection. And we don't have a stop going this way. There's a stop coming from the other two directions, but... Whatever, it's always the bike's fault. Anyways, let's move on to the next. I'm banging these videos out about halfway through already. So there is a car in front of this pickup truck here that has not a clue where they're going. And you don't stop in the middle of the road. Like, it's one thing being lost, it's another thing to just, like, stop. So luckily, I think anybody on a bike or anyone that could have squeezed in that spot would have passed them. It's like, I don't want to get stuck behind somebody like that. So, just, again, that is more of looking at the car past the car that's right in front of you, see, okay, what's actually going on? Can I safely kind of pass in the other direction? Or do I got to stay where I am? You know, sometimes you got to make that decision. But that decision for me was to pass everybody and get to where I'm going. So there's that. Let's move on to the next. This one is absolutely excruciatingly painful. And this is why I think they need to continually give people their driver's tests after so many years. So this lady starts off in that lane. It is three lanes here. Slams on her brakes with the blinker on. Doesn't actually switch lanes yet. Still on the brakes. Almost comes to a complete stop, merging onto the highway, which we have our own quarter mile lane here to go, and just doesn't hit the gas at all. It's just, I cannot overstate or understate this, how dangerous it is to not get up to speed going onto the highway. Like, that is much, much more dangerous than actually speeding onto the highway, because now you're blocking the people behind you, so you're getting backed up, or people trying to merge onto the highway, and it makes it more dangerous for the cars actually on the highway that are trying to get to where they're going. So there's that. If you learned anything from that clip, it's merge onto the highway at the appropriate speed. Let's move on to the next. And here we go. Four-way stop sign. Both coming up. Just, I don't think he had any intention whatsoever of actually coming to a complete stop. And then he saw me and he's like, oh, I'm going to brake a little bit, but he still went. Like, didn't even make a complete stop whatsoever. No, he just kept rolling. So, whatever. As long as us bikers make a complete stop, we should be okay. Let the other people blow the signs at this point. Like, I'm done, like, fighting them on it. It's like, hey, you want to go? You want to hit somebody? Fine. I'm going to sit here until it's safe to go. Let's move on to the next. So here's definitely an ongoing theme with the rest of my clips that I have here. And it's people just waiting and waiting and then pulling out in front of you, like this video, like this pizza guy. It's like all the time in the world, guy. And you're just like, nope, I'm just... And there's no... It's one of those clips. Perfect sight lines. There's no bushes, no trees, no nothing. And still, you just sit there and wait. And then you're like, I'm just going to go, again, slowly as possible, and go. Just always be aware of those side streets. Let's move on to the next. So here's an interesting one, and just a question to you guys. If this is the type of riding that you do, or that you would do in this type of situation, it gets really congested in certain areas in our city, and this is what I do sometimes. So as you can see, people are just kind of blowing the light and blocking the intersection there. No way to actually get into this lane here. So up here, there's a right-hand turn lane. My thought was like, hey, I'm just going to go and take a right. I can still get to where I'm going. And then I saw an opening. I'm like, oh, hey, I can just kind of squeeze in here and just go straight. I didn't, you know, left more than enough room here. That's definitely a couple, maybe a few car lengths. Double-checked, head-checked, made sure that car wasn't speeding up, and just kind of merge back into traffic. So, I don't know. I know some riders don't, they frown upon stuff like that. I don't know if you consider that lane splitting or what. I don't think it is really. It's just kind of, you know, I was going to take the right-hand turn lane over there. But, you know, it is what it is. I'd be interested in seeing what you guys think about that video. And while you're thinking about that video, let's move on to the next one. So, here is the perfect video for not speeding and not speeding through intersections while there's traffic. So you got a left-hand turn lane here, and this lane's to go straight. This lady just pops right out of that lane and just, like, with no rush whatsoever, and just goes. So you're about, what, like three cars deep. Lady just starts turning, like, yeah, I'm just going to go. And I know, you see these compilation channels all the time of these bikes just going, like, 60, 70 down roads like this, and stuff like this happens, you know, and when you're going that fast, you don't have enough time to really stop or react. Like, where are you going to go here? Let me get back here. So, you can't go to the left, because you got cars there. You can't go to the right, because, you know, there's curbs and poles. I mean, suppose if you're going fast enough, you'd go here. But you got nowhere to go. There's a parking lot. I mean, for me anyways, I saw it ahead of time, you can brake. Like, you know, if you're going fast enough or slow enough, maybe you can brake, but whatever. It's just stuff that you gotta watch out for. Let's move on to the next. Alright, so here's a clip that I know, at least on my part, that I was I want to say slightly wrong. No, I'm probably wrong for what I did in this clip, and I'd definitely be interested in what people thought about this, but we'll just play it. So, pulling up to light, blatantly green. And we run into this all the time. People are distracted looking at their phones. They don't actually look up and see what's going on. I beeped a couple times. He has no intention on really going, so I have enough room to pass him. Now, this guy thought he had enough room to go. Our light's still green. You can see that up here. So, as I'm passing him, yes, I'm on the throttle a little bit. Light's still green. And there's, as far as I know, yeah, there's no sign here. Usually there'd be a sign here saying no right on red. I can see why this guy might have thought he had some time to take a right on red. And then me coming around so quickly, I had to take slam on his brakes, which, good for him that he saw me. I actually appreciate that. And he had the, you know, heads up to stop. You know, he wasn't mad. You know, he just like hanging an arm out the window. But, yeah, I don't know. I probably could have... I mean, I probably would have passed this guy anyways because I was going straight, but I probably could have not been on the throttle as much and just kind of watched the intersection, but you live, you learn from your mistakes. Speaking of mistakes, let's go to this last clip. So, I have played this clip before, and it has its own separate video, but I just wanted to talk about it again for the very last Judge My Riding episode. I'm going to play it with sound, just straight up, and then we'll go back and we'll talk about it. That was the absolute closest call I've ever had while riding. And I'm still, to this day, have no idea where that car came from. So these guys, this guy's taking a right. I'm looking. You don't see headlights really in the back. I head check. So there's a guy directly behind me. But there's no one that I can see over in this lane. There's no headlights. Head check, check the mirrors. As soon as I start to turn, dude, where does this guy come from? Because it looks like he's over on, like... Because I'm in this lane. So he had to have seen me. Because he's over the yellow line at this point. And I don't know how we didn't hit. I really think that we may have brushed a little bit. Because there's no way he went all the way past me. And then without some sort of contact here. But that is... that's crazy. That's my closest call ever. So... Even if you do everything right, head check, check the mirrors, double check, make sure no one's coming. Stuff can happen, guys. So you got to, I don't know, you got to have your head on a swivel, 360 scanning all the time. So that is it from this last ginormous episode of Judge My Riding. Yes, I'm going to move on to something new for season 4. So we're ending with a nice even 10. So... Go down there, do all the fun YouTube stuff while you're down there. Leave me a comment, let me know that you like this episode, let me know that you like the series, and maybe I'll bring it back someday if enough people want it back. If the flock wants it, then the Black Phoenix will do it. And do the liking, do the subscribing, do all that fun YouTube stuff. I got some fun discount codes down there for you guys from BLR Tuning and from Ironside Customs. Check out those links. And with all that being said, I appreciate you guys rocking with the flock. I'll see you guys on the next video.